Hey guys, welcome back to Transport Fever. Now let's play episode number 2. Skip through to 1865, so I think I skipped through a fair few years. Got a bit of money in the bank. Back to the 3 million loan. Making a little bit of profit. There was something I wanted to do. If I can work out how to do it. Logo. No logo. Okay, I did do a new logo, but it obviously hasn't worked. Yeah, it's not there, so I'll have to go back and check and forget what I did wrong there. But the plan for this video will be, obviously these guys are struggling to keep up. I'm thinking I may need to put a road, fingers crossed, a road out here, and maybe put in medium street. Can't attach to that. Can we come out a bit further? If we can. Maybe whack in a train station there, because we're going to need, fingers crossed, we're going to need to get some more stuff over here in a lot quicker. So we can either do it this way, which doesn't really, have a look at the industrial area, doesn't really pick up everything, or we could always put one in here, which will pick up the whole lot. But the issue there is, too much slope. So where's too much slope? I'd like to stick one in here somewhere, but the issue is too much slope is which way? With the road or with the track? Okay. What I'll do is get as close as I can to this guy, bump it out a little bit, give us a bit of extra space. Bam, whack it in there. I'll also need to whack in a station down here, which I don't really want an end station, because we can take some, if we want to, we can take some construction components over to Fresno, I think it is, I've got there. So, try and zoom in a little bit. I want to get a little bit of extra road on there. Go back to rail, head across. So we want to sort of have it not angled too much. Now I'd like two tracks, just so we can, if you want to, we can head over to the other town as well. So bang, two tracks here. Now we need to join these two up. Obviously this will start to disappear once this gets set, and we'll have to get all these trucks off that run, but that's fine. So we'll head out. I want to do like a slight curve. I don't want to be curving too far, so you want to keep that speed up as much as we can. Head forward. I might come out a little bit. Obviously it's going to cost us a little bit to get down from there because of the bit of slope on the land. So beautiful. That's that connected. Now we're going to need a depot, so I want to come a fair way out. We'll come out to here somewhere. Whack a depot in there. We probably don't need it that far out, but in the past I've had troubles connecting, so we've obviously used this depot to go into the other line as well. So now bring up the lines. New line. We want to go from here to here. We want to make sure that's yellow. We'll change the name to Austin Construction Train. Get rid of that and that. Now we want to build another train, so we want to buy a train. We don't have a lot of money on us, so we're going to have to take out another small loan. So one train, just take out 500. How many carriages can we get? Construction materials, 7. 218, so maybe 3. Three shall do. We'll set it to the Austin Construction Train. We'll change it to Austin Construction T1. Hit speed number 1. Get this guy going, and we keep a close eye on this here. This should start. Just double check I did the right thing there. So It has. It's accepted that. I didn't even look. We need to make sure next time we are actually accepted by that construction yard there. Construction station won't work. So construction. Let's put construction yard. That'll do. Now we need to change this to Austin. Austin. Let's change it to industrial. Receiving will it work? R-E-C-I-V-I-N. No, REC will do. So that's where we receive our industrial staff. Now let's have a quick look. If I want to upgrade, what will happen here? Two tracks, three, four. If we go to eight, can we do it? We can, but we don't have enough money, but that's fine. Length of track, we can't. Yeah, we can't upgrade our length of track, which is unfortunate. Maybe if we drop off some tracks, will that help? No, it won't. Unfortunately, it won't. But it's probably colliding with our the rail that's on the ground, so that's fine. What I'll do is bump the speed up to 3. See if we start receiving some stuff in here. Check on these guys and see if they... No, there we go. It's starting to slowly receive things, which is good. I don't want to overdo it and be taking more than we can handle. But here comes another stone ship now. Another one's on his way back. So obviously when they jump in here and bump this up, they've got 125 stored already, but he's coming in with 34 on board. 117,000. It's more money in the bank. Got 18 here, so we can take 21, so we might have a full load for our first trip. Now this should dwindle down to 0. I don't think they will send construction material to both spots because it's quicker to go this way than it is to go this way. So he's got a full load on. Let's have a look. It's a nice bright yellow, that is. He's heading into Austin's station, our industrial receivings area. Get rid of that again. Get rid of our land use, we don't need to see that. But here we come for our first delivery. 97,000. So that's definitely put us above what it's going to cost us. Hopefully, those funds can stay. We've got 23 there ready to go already. So another passenger train heading in. Not sure if I did it on camera, but I bumped it up to 5 carriages, which takes now 70 people. It's only 45 to go back, but there was at stages there. Sometimes there is 70 other people there waiting to go, so really want to make sure that we've got enough people. So I think Austin was going to go to El Paso, wasn't it? Or we're going to send him over to Marino. Or Fontana. It's a long way to go to Fontana, but I think they have more people. So 265, Marino's got 163. El Paso's 208, so we're probably better off going into Fontana if we can. We can have a look over here. As I said, we've got iron ore into here, into there. We'd probably do the one train, to be honest. Send him in and then back out and into there. That'll be pretty cool, but the land's not going to help us there, that's for sure. But we could. The land is definitely going to be a pain there, unless we sort of go around. Well, that's going to be hard too with all these roads here. But somehow demolish all this and bump through here and go in. And in and in, yeah. That's a possibility, we could do that. Iron ore just to here. Should have a coal just to there. So we could even do that, put a station here. The train will go from here to there with coal, iron, or from there to there. Backwards, like a one lane thing, would be pretty cool. Let's have a look now. Where's our train? Oop, we want to click on the train. There he is. So he's on his way back for his second trip. Full load again. We've still got 24 left behind, so we may need to put some more carriages on, but obviously we don't want to do it just yet. Don't want to go out too hard too soon, especially with carriages and stuff. It only increases your running costs and that sort of thing. We should get another 97,600 from this guy. Bam, 97,600, beautiful. And he'll head back for another full load, and we've still got 45 there. Still got 55 in here, so we need to monitor this. As I said, we keep an eye on that. Just having a bit of a look. We've got colder there, colder here. Got two lots of food there, and there's food to there. Now, the other thing is, we could put in a railway from here to here, but does it produce one or both? We could get it so it produces both, I think. The other issue is we'll need a road. So let's do that. Let's just wing it and have a go at that. We'll put in a small country road. We'll go from here to here. From here to here. Now we put in another an end station, because we're not going anywhere else. We want to try and put him up this end, just in case we want to whack some more. It's definitely, comes a save, definitely highlighted here, so try and square it up a bit. There we go. Bam, whack that in there. Now we will put in a road from there to there, and there to, say, into there. Go back to our station. We want to put in one of these ones, and it will accept that, so that's perfect. Other option we have is one train that goes from here to here to here and then back again, which is a possibility as well. Depending, obviously, food goes into commercial buildings. So we're going to have to try and get right in the centre of the city here somewhere, which is going to be a bit difficult. So we'll whack that in as well. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, so we're going to need to try and get into here somewhere. So which one's... Well, land value's $50 a square metre, I think that is. So that's 51,000 to get rid of that one. This one is 151. This one is, it takes out 2301. So if we go, we need to try and just get this one building out of the way. There. Now, can we get a road onto there? We can, without demolishing anybody else. Put in an end depot. Have to swing him around. Now, it doesn't get all the blue, but it gets a fair chunk of it. So what if we try that? Does that get all of it? It's pretty close to it. Put that in here and try and get as far down there as we can without, bam, without demolishing anybody else. Yeah, we'll get this line set up. Going to struggle a bit money-wise for a train, but 39,000. Right, ground looks fairly flat, so we can make sure it's connected. Off we go. Bam, that's in. Now we want to slowly curve this one out this way, and I want to try as best as we can to bring this straight without chewing up too much of the ground. Come back down here, have another bit of a look. Still need a bit of a curve, not too much. Bring these together. Bam, that's that done. Now that should be fully connected. So fingers crossed for you. Head back to a new line. We go new line from here to here to here. Now it's commercial, so we want... we've already got dark blue for rail lines, haven't we? For bus lines. Maybe we need to change them to green, I think. So we'll change that to dark blue. That'll be... Chicago, isn't it? So Chicago, livestock food. Livestock food. Oh, how about we just go livestock farm food train. There we go. Sounds good to me. Righto, grab this one. Change it to green. Ooh, that's probably too lime green for my liking. Second one from the bottom. This other one. Second one from the top, I should say. Now, we haven't got any money for a train, so we can borrow more money if you like. Let's have a look and see where things are. We've got heaps of stuff in here waiting. We've got one stone ship on the way back. This guy's got how much on? 50 people. 40 waiting to come back. Now, let's have a look at our lines. Is that guy making money? That's the question. 158,000, he certainly is. It's only the shipping, stone shipping stuff that's not making money, but it will. This thing is going absolutely nuts. We're going to have to put some more carriages on this guy as well to make a bit more money. It's 44 left. Oh, they're still gaining a little bit, so we could probably keep a couple of trucks on this run. I thought I'd completely not use it, so that's 80. We're only taking 21, so we should be taking 40 at a time. We won't for now. We're still making money, so we'll leave it. This guy's heading into here. Now, what do we do? Do we just bite the bullet and go bugger it? Let's just borrow another mill. Because I don't want to be sitting here doing nothing. So let's do it. We'll borrow another mill. Slow the speed back down because you guys don't want to just watch the speed, the money going up and down and stuff. You want to actually watch and see what I'm doing. So didn't work. Right, bring it off here. Got to put in another depot, obviously, for a train. So train depot. Oop, swing him around. Let him connect there. Beautiful. Now, as far as I know, if we buy a train, we want the dark blue. Oh, we want a good one. Oh, what's the 28.7 a year, 52.9 per year. I don't think it's really worth the extra 5Ks, to be honest, so we'll just go the smaller one. Now, we've got grain for that one, and where's our livestock in this one? So we're going to need one, two of those, and two boxcars for livestock. And also food, so that's fine. So we grab three. Ooh, we can't even get three. Speed her up a bit. See if we can get three shortly. Fingers crossed. Rename this while we're here. If I remember what it was called. Look, quickly grab one more. Slow it down. Set him on his way. Chicago Farm Food Train. So the name will be Chicago Farm Food T1. Now, fingers... Yeah, we know. We know, but we haven't got the money for that just yet. I think, do we have it so it's set automatically? No, we don't, so that's fine, doesn't matter. I'd like to keep an eye on this guy and see how he goes. Also, it's got livestock and coal there, but it should. Do we pick the right one? Gondola? So it does grain as well, so that should be fine. So what we'll do now is, they've got stuff waiting, so turn around, you head to Cedar Rapids. So we're going to do, call it Cedar Rapids Farm Station, if we can. So he's got three grain, three livestock on board, perfect. Now, this is a food processing plant. So we've got Chicago Food Processing, what did we call the last one? Station, isn't it? Chicago Food Station So now he's going to run into here with nothing on, but that's fine. So we want Chicago Commercial Receiving. Now how much have we got here? We don't want... Oh, we've got 14 grain we can have and 7... 14 grain, I should say, and 21 livestock, so... Let's have a good look at him. Nice dark blue there. Obviously, he's not going to make any money here. But fingers crossed, if we can zoom out and have a look, this guy will be producing food soon. Now, we don't want... We'll try and avoid, if we can, him stopping here. If he doesn't do that, we're going to have to put in another line, because if he picks up food from here, it means we're going to get less stuff from up here. So... let's have a look at him. So you keep chugging through. Yep, chug, off he goes. That's what we want. Obviously in debt again. So the food train's not making any money, but shortly, hopefully you will. Going to get a full load of grain from here. Close to a full load of livestock. So we may need one more grain carriage. So we get a full load. Now we got 19, and we would have had 19 of each. So we'll see how we go for livestock. If we head back and it still hasn't got 19, then we know we only need one more grain. We don't need any more livestock carriages. So you drop off there, 121,000. So he's still down a little bit for income, but he's got 7 food on, 7 of 7. Obviously, you can fit more. You can fit up to 14 food. And this is the only reason why we won't make sure the carriages only carry livestock, because you want it to be able to carry livestock and then carry the food as well. So, which is a bit weird having food in a livestock carriage where the livestock's obviously done their business. So we head back. So livestock, we've only got 9 at the moment. We're still in the red just. We've got 28,000 for that. So the food, we're not really making as much out of food as I would have hoped. But hopefully they're going to start processing a little bit more. Process is 60. They've got 25 stored. So if they can get some more to us, we'll definitely deliver it. Keep an eye on him again. Heading back down, we've got a lot stored. So livestock, we want to try and make sure we've got 21 there, but I don't think we're going to make 21. 14 food. So when we head back there, we may have be close to 21, maybe close to full load. So we're definitely going to need, I think, one more grain carriage. So we've still got a lot of grain left behind, so... food train's also full, right from the food station. Try and get this money back down again. It's definitely be a good earner, I think. So we're going to have well over our 3 carriages of food here. So we could probably get another 2 grain, another 1 food. It's a possibility. So we're full of food. We're still at 11 left behind, so... I'm thinking on our next trip back, we've got 500,000, so that's enough for another livestock and another grain carriage. But if we can, we'll try and get another 2 grain and another 1 livestock. Because we're definitely making a profit now, aren't we? Oh, we're close to it. Now, let's just go 86,000, so we're in profit now. So but we need to keep that profit up. We've nearly got 21 food there already, so we definitely need one more livestock. Could even do with a second train on this run eventually, but we don't want to go out too hard, too fast. As I've said thousands of times, so wait for this guy to head down closer to station, we'll turn him around, send him back into here, and hopefully, money-wise, we'll have enough to put... We want two more grain, one more food carriage. Money's dwindling away, it's not helping. 403 we want. Yeah, that'll do us. If we can get in now, nice and quick. Oh, turn around, turn up, oh, turn around. Depot, go. We need you to go quick. Well, we've got the money there. We want dark blue. We want to pause the game now while we can. So we want a gondola, which has got grain. We want two of those. Can we afford another boxcar? I think we can. Which is livestock, beautiful. So now, okay, we want to, can we move? We need to take these out, and that out, and then put these back in. So it's all lined up nice and well. Food train. Want to get him going again. We'll speed him right up. We're going to have a full train. We know, actually need to keep an eye on that before I forget. There's still plenty here, still 27, there's still heaps here, so we really should bump this guy up as well. Have a look at his finances, he's definitely making money, could make a lot more. So here we go, we'll head back and have a look at our brand new train, all the grain sitting there and livestock. Still going to be a lot left behind. Actually, livestock, yeah, it was pretty full livestock. Grain was still got a little bit left behind, but... Well, no, we're definitely going to have a full load of food. So the train's going to definitely, I'm thinking, he's definitely going to start making a lot more money than he was. So we were up last year. See if we can get a bit more profit again this year. Really come with food. There's well over 40 food in here, so we're gonna have a full 205. So look at that, well and truly above. Now we're gonna get 28 food. How much we got left? 10. So we could do with another carriage, but I'm not gonna push it. I think that's probably well and truly more than enough. We could have even got a faster train. It's only 5Ks, but it will make it a bit shorter for the trip. Let's have a look. Every 8 minutes. I think that means it's a full circuit. Austin Stone Shipping North has got 50 of 50 stone on board, which is great. It's what we want to see. Now, what sort of profit do we make this time? 115,000. So, 151,000 ahead there. So that's a good find that was. Now we've got another farm here, and another grain one here. So we can go from here to here to here maybe. Or here to here to here. That's a possibility, from here to here to here. Have a look at the blue. It's, unfortunately, it's right in the city again. Makes it hard. Better if it was just here or just there or just this side, but that's more. That's another thing we can do, more livestock over there. Obviously, money is what we're going to need to keep bringing in to get that done. He's got a full train this time. Definitely struggling to get through there. 16 on board, and he's the station, I should say, once he got on board. 21. He's chugging away nicely up the hill. Now let's see if these guys are happy. The delivery that we're delivering 80%, so it's good. We just could do with some fuel in there now to try and make him even happier, and even some machines. Is there any fuel around anywhere? Fuel there, or crude oil there, and there's a fuel station there, so it's a long hike. Any down here anywhere closer? No, there's not. So obviously more grain here, so we can go from here to here to there, from there to there to there, maybe sort of do a loop-de-loop. More there, there's just no food area around. Also they take grain as well. So makes, what's it, plastics? Yeah, plastics, so a lot of stuff we can get done. still a lot of stuff waiting here. Probably not. Will there be 28 waiting of each? Definitely 28 of grain, obviously. Keep a close eye on it. He's on his way in. 21 and 44. Obviously, we could have kept just three carriages of livestock, but there's 28 there already, so this farm's producing a lot. Still got a lot of grain left behind, but could always put in like a road as well and do a little bit of grain by road, but it's working well. It's making money if we have a look. Where is he? North, only 39,000 at this point in time, but it's getting close to the end of the year, so money is money. Chicago's happy. Yeah, they're mediocrely happy with their food, so it's not too bad. We've still got a stone ship heading in, which is just about there. They've increased their production limit to 200, which is great for us. 48 stored, so now they're going to pump out some construction materials, obviously, now. So we really need these ships to keep up with the demand there, I guess you call it. Slow it down, have a look. We did get a new ship, but does it take? It only takes oil and fuel and crude oil, so this guy's got heaps of stone there waiting to go. So is this one. So what do we do now? The limit's been bumped up. Do we go like this and say we need some more stone ships? Is that the plan? Is that what we should do? I'm thinking we may need to, like, either that or we can train it. But I'm thinking train will be a little bit slower, so okay, we buy two. South, off they go. Change their name. Hopefully I haven't gone out too fast. Stone ship 2, or south 2 I should say. Austin stone ship south 2. Austin stone ship south 3. Now, I don't want them going that far by boat, so let's whack in a depot here. I know it's not too pricey. There we go. Buy another two more. Make sure we set it to stone because we don't want them picking up things to bring back. Buy two. Oop, not enough money. Okay, well, we'll set him on his way. North. Austin stone ship north 2. How much do we need? 187,000 we're going to need, so let's keep an eye on this so we can get another one nice and quick. There's three of them all on their way. Big payday when they get there, that's for sure. Just over half an hour into the video, or into this episode, so we've got a bit of time to get this other guy going. With the Wilhelm 1. You've got the riggy for passengers and the roaster. It's like a roller coaster. Well, there's another one. Set him on the north line. Austin stone ship north 3. Beautiful. Keep an eye on this. Let's have a ride on board with this one. See the other two stone ships are all pushing hard to get there first. Heading over there, rocking away. We overtaken the other ship, we're not, but we could sort of see him. So we've got, he's not. Turn around, head the other way. Yep, you got nothing on board, mate. These guys got anything on board? Yep, 50, 50, oh, nothing. Oh, that's a shame. It's waiting for a big payday then. They're all heading there with nothing. Is this guy... You can't actually... Oop, new horse trolley car. Another new train. Beautiful. It won't actually turn around, unfortunately. So we've got four going there, and this guy's got... The only thing that's got anything on board, so... Let's have a look at our new train. We've got 280 Baldwin Class 56, 60 kilometres an hour. That's a huge bonus for us. That's what we need. 114,000 a year, which is way more than everybody else. But this guy, is he still making money? He is, but there's nothing waiting there, unfortunately. Now we'll go like this. We'll go these guys, this, send them all to the depot. We'll get rid of this line. Now, where's our other depot here? By road vehicles. Didn't we just get a new road vehicle? Or is it a tram that we just got? I don't know. I thought it was a road vehicle that we just got. There's nothing else there, so maybe not. So he's going to go backwards and forwards and nothing on at this point in time. They've got no production because they've got nothing stored. These guys... He's got 50 on. Nothing. Now, if I stop him, can we turn him around? Because he needs to head to Fresno Stone Shipyard. So do we need to stop them before we turn them around? No, it's not working. Okay. Never mind. Is this the guy that's got something on board? No, that guy has. So this has three terminals. Why are they waiting here? You should be heading straight in, mate. You don't really need a bottleneck there at this point in time. Holy crap. Look at this. Got a massive amount of stuff waiting here. Wow, what are we going to do here? Should we put in a second train? Maybe with a bypass or something? We've got no money at this point in time, but I think that might be a good idea. We come down here and we bypass this station, put in a faster train. Put in like a couple of slip lanes, I guess you call them. Come on, we need some more money to get that to happen. He's just dropped off, so 46 stored. We just need that to keep up with that train, otherwise that train's going to start losing money. Yeah, we'll slow the speed down because we've got some money here. Oop, we don't want that. We want this to come out. Maybe like that. Swing him through, join him up here somewhere. Bang. Now we want to put in a signal. Is that right or that way? That way. So we need to bring up that line to have a look. Chicago Farm Food Train. Now, if we go single, whoop, one way, no, it's not going to work. Maybe I've made a mistake with this one. Where are you going, my friend? Maybe, oh, okay, because that's not connected properly. That's why, unfortunately. Made a bit of a boo-boo there. We need to get him to join. That'll do. That's what we want. Okay, so whereabouts is there? So if you one lane this, yes. One lane this, yes. Now, the signal's on that side. So the signal on this side, we may need to put that side and one lane it, yes. One lane, yes. Will he go the right way? He has, perfect. So look at all the stuff I've got here. So I'm going to have to make another... Oop, slow it down again, we've got a bit more monies. I'm going to try and keep the speed up to 120, head it down. Join that and that together. Obviously it's going to be a fairly expensive task. That side and maybe this side, oh, is it? I can't remember, no, it's not that side, it's the inside, isn't it? I haven't got enough money for that now. Come on, money. Whoop, another vehicle. American horse cart. Okay, beautiful. Let's have a look at this one. So it's that way. Yes. Whoop, where is it? Here it is. This way, yes. Where is he? He's already there. So maybe now we'll go down and have a quick look at that, shall we? Are they all in here? Yep, so we'll get rid of all these guys. We don't need them anymore. By road vehicles. American horse cart takes 5 instead of 4. And it does an extra 5 kilometers an hour, so it's not really worth it. Look at this depot, we've got some in here as well. Beautiful. Still short on money, so where's all our ships? He's heading back. Full load. Full load. Still heaps left behind, so let's speed up again. Look at all the stuff I've got up here. It's got stuff everywhere. Mainly more grain than livestock, so... How much grain have we got there? 83. Wow. So I'm going to borrow a bit. Well, probably not enough. We want to go this one, dark blue, buy. Now we need, where are we? Gondola for grain. So we want 2, 3, still not enough. Grab another mill. I know we're a lot of money out, so we'll grab 5 of those. And how much has he got here? Heaps. Let's buy trains. I might need some more money again. Dark blue. 1, 2. Well, okay. 3, 4, 5. No. 5. 5 of each. Set him on this one. Now Chicago farm food T2, thinking that's what it was supposed to be called. Obviously we've got a lot of money. Oh, loan interest isn't too bad, 45,000 a year. It might be a bit more this year now, but so you can take 35 of each. It's probably not enough livestock to fill us up. It's definitely enough grain to fill us up. Livestock will fall short, but look at the grain, so that's fine. There's definitely going to be enough food here to fill us up, but this train, we're going to have to bump him up to similar to him and make him 60 kilometers an hour as well. He might not even get full speed before he makes it, to be honest. 57, 58, 59. Oh, we got to 59. So 241 for that, which is awesome. Now he should come through to here and then he'll stop, because you'll have to wait for this guy to come through. For this guy, we want to fix him up. Full load of food on. How much have we got left? Still got 97 left. So we want one of each carriage, and we also want the faster train on the front. This could be a good earner for us, I'm thinking. Obviously, the livestock's not through the roof, unfortunately. Oh, should we just leave it? Let's just leave it for now, I think, because there's only 7 livestock there, so obviously this guy's a lot quicker than this train. Finances, 385,000 he's made already. But we need him to keep his money coming. Now let's go back down and have a look. Construction materials doing well. Have a look. Finances didn't make money last year, but that's because we weren't getting enough stone in. How's the stone looking? Still heaps of stone. 200 limit. It's only 100 limit, so that needs to be bumped up, hopefully very shortly. Everything here is looking fairly good. This is just going nuts, so he's on his way in. He's going to get a full load of grain. No livestock at all that time, unfortunately. No, that's a shame. It's like they're not producing enough livestock. Not as fast as grain by the looks of it. So 2 grain, 3 grain, 4 grain, 5 grain, 6 grain. They're not producing enough livestock. 7 grain to 1 livestock. This guy's just making money. We've nearly just turned him into just a bloody food train. Because that grain is going through the roof. So he's stopped there again waiting for us. How's his income? 94,000 last year. $43,000, so he's definitely going ahead, but he's catching this guy way too quick. So our only other option is to get rid of this train altogether. Because the only thing I'm concerned about is that livestock. This is not going quick enough. This guy, I'm thinking we shall get rid of him. So once we get past, we'll send him to the depot. We'll just sell it all and then monitor this other train. So he's going to be stuck there waiting for a little bit now. But look at the livestock, there's just 8. There's not enough. It's more than enough grain, but not enough livestock. So how about we sell? How much money do we get back? 1.4 mil. So that's a bit of that loan gone. Only 5 mil borrowed now. Let's keep an eye on this guy. Full load of grain again. 14 livestock. That's not too bad. Look at the food we've got here, though. That's just nuts. But I don't want to just have one train. This guy's doing a pretty good job going around and around, so. Look at his finances. He's down again at this point in time, but he'll bump it up now to be in profit of 142,000. So we can put some more grain on. Even food, like the food's just... Oh, the production of that food has gone through the roof already. So is this. Potential of 170 product, but they're just... Yeah. Hopefully it's going to bump it up now, but... What do we do now? Is this the time that we split all this up? And just have one train running this way. Now, the issue we're going to have now is if we upgrade this station to, say, 2 wide or even 3 wide, it's going to remove all of this stuff. Remove all the food and all the livestock and grain. So that's the other issue that we're going to have. How's this going? Absolutely smashing it. 82 in stock. Stone. We've still got heaps of stone. 89. 86. He's got 50 on. Both these guys are going to come back with 50, fingers crossed. 95, how about we send you to the depot? Buy trains. Shall we bump you up to the new train? Slow it down, how about? Sell that. Can we buy that? No, we can't. We need a bit more money. So we buy that one. Now, still only 21. We need a couple more carriages on this guy, I think. We may not use them all, but what do we need? State cars for construction materials. Now we head him back on construction train line. Get rid of that and that. Nice bright yellow there. So we'll end this episode shortly. We're up to 50 odd minutes. Work out what we want to do for the next one. So we picked up 35. There's still 72 left behind. There's some ships nice and close, so we're not... They should hopefully keep up now, as long as we keep that production of stone up. It shall keep the production of construction materials up, so... $210,000, that's what we want. So obviously it's going to cost us more to run that train, but he's going to make it backwards and forwards a lot quicker. Hopefully these doesn't affect it too much with the stone ships being a bit slow. Now the train is up here. Let's have a look again. No, I want to click on the train. He's up. So we'll repay another part of this loan. I want to get this loan completely gone, just in case I need to borrow money for something. So food, 127, pumping it out. It's got heaps of grain there, more livestock coming through now that they've upgraded to 200 limit. They're also at 200, so I'm not sure on how high these goes before these guys go before they max out. So we've still got crude oil here. Where can that go to? Up here. So we could always do like a train from here to here as well. A lot of options. A train from there to there to there. Yeah, that's another option. I like the idea of having them do more than just one thing. Especially later in the game when you get a lot faster trucks. A train, sorry. So it's nearly a full load of everything with this guy. I'm going to keep an eye on our money. Put it up here out of the way so I can repay when we've got enough. What does he make? 322. Now look at that. Income through the roof of that guy. Gonna get another full load. Still gonna have heaps behind. So we could nearly just... The only issue there is last, we could nearly just go with two trains. From here to here to here to here. But yeah, just one this way and one that way. Money is the issue, as per usual, and also we don't want to go out too hard too fast. So it's 59 waiting there, 57 waiting there. We need to keep an eye on that we haven't put too many ships on the run. A new stagecoach and a new clever story passenger car. So I want to get rid of that, that, and that. We can have a look at this now. The stagecoach will take 5 passengers instead of 4. So what we'll do now is head into here. We've got a bus line. Oops. Set vehicle. We'll change it to a stagecoach. And it is the green. Done. This one, change it. Set vehicle to a stagecoach. Dark green. Done. Austin Fresno Rail. We want that to be replaced at 200,000. Now that's dark red. We want that. Now 14 or 16. So 16, 32. Will that be enough? 16, 32, 48. That might be enough. It's 2.1 million. Bam, we'll do that, we'll just do that. See how that goes. Construction train. We want to replace that 200%. We want to put this one in. It is yellow. We want a state car. We want construction materials. 1, 2, 3, 4. Have we got 4 on this one? 5. So 5. That's replaced. They will get replaced when they're ready to go. This one will need to 200%. Yeah. Oh, set vehicle. Now this is dark blue, isn't it? Yes. we want 5 of each, so that's this one, stone, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then also boxcar, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes, get rid of that, that should be, yes, before I forget, Fresno rail, did we not do that? No, we need to press yes, so they're all going to get replaced when they need to, we'll just, money. So that guy, 74 there, he's heading back, these other guys are still heading away. More money in the bank. Get this loan down a little bit. And I think, so all we've done really is whacked in a construction train line, put an extra 2 ships on this run. We've made this setup here, which I think is working really well. This guy is making over 500,000 a year. We've still got shitloads of grain here and shitloads of food here, so something we can look at, maybe, obviously we need to have a quick look, we'll zoom in, have a look, when it hits 2 we'll count. So we'll speed it up. So 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so you got 5 grain to 1 livestock. So saying that, for every 1 carriage of livestock you want 5 carriages of grain, I think, yeah, or close to 4 carriages of grain. So we could do that, we could do say 2 livestock, 8 grain, and backwards and forwards. It's only a short run, but, or 1 livestock and say 5 grain, and then this guy just doing food backwards or forwards, but we can look at that later on. Still got a lot of passengers here wanting to get to Austin. We still want to join Austin with Fontana and Marino and Midland and Fresno with Midland and Denton and stuff, so still a lot of stuff to do. Getting through to 1875 now, so we're getting starting to start getting some better vehicles that we can use. Obviously with our road vehicles, we can use an American horse cut now, which isn't much different. Stagecoach, only 1 extra passenger, 1 extra item of goods with the other ones as well, so it's not really worth it. As far as ships go, still nothing new. We can't do planes yet. The trains already know what the new stuff is with the trains, so we've got the 3 trains available now. So yeah, we'll call that episode number 2. Like, comment, subscribe, let me know what you think we should do. Should we do, say, 1 livestock to 5 grain into here and then just do smash this with food into there? Is that what we should do, or should we keep it as it is? Obviously, it's not keeping up with demand and supply. So demand's probably through the roof. No, it's only good, so we can still put a bit more food into there. So we can do that. Just, yeah, as I said, comment, let me know what we think we should do. Still going to keep paying this loan off as we go. Might fast forward through till say 1880 and come back then, and we'll get something else sorted for there. So thanks for watching our Let's Play with Transport Fever. It's been episode number 2. I'll see you in episode number 3. Thanks for watching. Ciao for now.